I remember when I first went plant-based, my mum and dad were like, you know, my whole life, eat your vegetables, eat your vegetables. And I went plant-based and they were like, well, what are you going to eat? And I was like, this is what you've wanted my whole life. And now I'm plant-based. They're like, eat some chicken. My favourite thing about writing songs is the opportunity to put it into like a time capsule and know that it's going to exist forever. It's like a gift that never disappears.
My food is my expression of who I am. And as a chef, you're very fortunate if you get to truly express yourself. You're just trying to put yourself out there.
So, do you live in LA?
I grew up in LA.
Amazing. Tell me what you love about LA.
One, the weather,
yeah,
and the diversity. Some of the best food in LA is in some of the outlying neighborhoods. Mainstream LA is starting to discover some of the Latino neighborhoods. That's what's so cool about LA, is like every neighborhood's like almost a different city. I think it's like a choose your own adventure city.
You've got a bit of beach, bit of city.
You can hike, you can
exactly.
You can rage.
In that order too, hike and then rage. Yeah.
Arcadia, if you like Indian food.
I love Indian food.
It's a Londoner in you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you grew up on
and
it.
East London too. I love the opportunity here. You know, and I think that you just have to really, I'm going to quote one of my own songs here. Stay
okay.
True to who you
do
are.
That,
where's the
that.
Camera so I can look straight
do
in
that.
There?
Yes.
LA's changed me.
You're quoting yourself. This is
I'm
awesome.
I'm quoting myself.
Yeah,
and
it.
I've got it tattooed on me, but
do
wrong.
It.
How cringe. It was my own fault. I spelt it wrong. I have my own lyrics spelt wrong, tattooed on my body.
Wow.
Okay. Yeah. And when people come to LA, they think of Hollywood. They go into this weird mindset that they have to like shift who they are to fit in. And for me, like the more I've just celebrated what makes me stand out and makes me eccentric, the easier it's been. So there's always a couple side eyes,
totally.
You know? There's always like the savage in the darkness, but.
Savage in the darkness should be a song.
Savage in the darkness should be a song.
That's a song.
Bye guys. Food for me is a huge part of my survival as a musician.
We gotta take care of the instrument.
Yeah.
You know? Cooking is such a physical thing. Cooking
yeah.
in a restaurant is like...
Oh, I can't even imagine.
Full contact sport.
I think if I was in a kitchen, I'd just shout all the time.
It sounds like you're really cut out to be a chef.
I can shout. I mean, I could be like the first singing chef, you know? We got 5 steaks. How would you describe you're cooking?
You know, someone asked me like, how do you write a menu? And it's like, it's writing an album.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, and then there might be hits.
Yeah.
You might have 1, 2, 3, you know, sometimes, you know, you
yeah.
get your B-sides,
yeah.
you know, you got your favorites, the dishes
exactly.
that are very personal
exactly.
to you.
It's a social experience for everybody that comes in and everybody has their favorite. How are you as a chef, as a head chef in a kitchen? Are you loud?
No, not anymore. I used to be.
Right.
I was a total, you know.
Savage in the dark.
Savage in the dark again, yeah. This song's just gonna write itself.
I'm a savage in the darkness. I know it's country, straight country.
Yeah.
I went plant-based about 2.5 years ago, basically went cold turkey. So, you know, I used to eat meat and
you
I
went plant-based cold turkey.
I should change it, cold
change
tempeh.
It. Yeah.
I went cold tempeh. Since I went plant-based, my skin, my sleep, my moods, my energy, my survival on jet lag has improved immensely. My health has improved immensely.
Well, we have a burger, and like, I know how much you love Indian food.
Yes.
It's very Indian inspired. I mean, we're taking you back to your London upbringing, and I think you'll like it.
So where is it?
For the burger, I made a charred eggplant, and then I took the Light Life plant-based burger and I crusted it in garam masala, charred it on the grill, and then I made a vegan coconut raita, and then some fresh arugula, and a bun inspired by naan.
Ta-da! Can we just go for it? Okay, here we go. So good, so soft. I like food to not be dry, and sometimes burgers can be really dry.
Yeah.
This is so good. Well, it looks like meat in the middle, doesn't it?
It actually reacts and cooks a lot like meat, and it actually chars just like meat. When I eat this, it doesn't feel like I'm missing something.
Come on!
You know?
Maybe that's what the burger should be called, I don't miss meat. Whoa!
It's not like a great veggie burger, it's just like a great burger.
Mm. This burger's amazing.
Thank you.
I can feel the thought and energy and love that has gone into this. I appreciate it. Can we cheers our burgers?
Let's do that.
And then just take one last bite. Eye contact. Cheers. Okay.